What's up guys, I am Rob, welcome to my channel. So today I have a very interesting DIY project for you guys. But before I talk about that, I have a request to make. You see that subscribe button right there? Please click on that and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, then click on the bell notifications icon so that you are updated every time I put a new video up. So today I'm going to show you guys how you can print a t-shirt using a glue gun and some bleach. Sounds interesting? Then get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's get started. So today I'm going to show you guys a super simple technique of printing a t-shirt using a glue gun and some bleach. Yes, you heard me right. We are using a glue gun and bleach and we are going to print on a t-shirt. So what I'm going to do is I am going to make a stencil on my t-shirt using hot glue. And as soon as that dries up, I am going to spray some bleach on it. What will happen is bleach is going to change the color of the fabric. The fabric will become lighter as soon as it gets in contact with the bleach. But wherever we have our hot glue stencil, that area will remain intact because it won't get in contact with bleach. And when you remove the hot glue stencil, you will be able to see the pattern or design revealed there. Now you can make any design or pattern you like. You can make a squiggly pattern, you can make a checkered pattern, you can make straight lines or wavy lines, or you can even write something with hot glue. But I am going to pick something that is more defined, like this. You all know I'm a big Spider-Man fan, so I'm gonna make this spider on my t-shirt and also draw a web around it. I think this will look really nice with this bleach printing technique. I have a feeling it will look like the Spider-Man costume. So our sketch is here, let's print this on a t-shirt. So here I have a plain black t-shirt. This is a cotton t-shirt. You have to make sure you take a cotton t-shirt. If it's not pure cotton, then the bleach will not work so well on it. Now what we need to do is we need to put something inside to create a separation layer so that when you put bleach on this or your glue gun on this, it shouldn't get transferred to the back of the t-shirt. So you can put newspaper, mount board, cardboard, whatever you have. So I'm gonna just open the t-shirt and put a sheet of mount board inside. Okay, my t-shirt is ready. I have my reference with me. Now let's make a stencil. Alright, so you can see our hot glue stencil is ready, looks nice and clean. Actually, this looks like a 3D embossed print. Looks pretty cool, like so cool that I would just wear it like this because this looks like something that you would buy from a store. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. For the next step, I have my bleach ready in a water spray. Now you can also apply bleach using a brush, but I think water spray works better if you want a gradient or a vignette kind of effect. Also, you have to keep some tissue paper handy. I have a toilet roll here. This is just to dab the excess bleach because the excess bleach can seep under the stencil and it can damage your design. All right, let's get started. So I'm starting from the center and I'm gonna spray a little bit of bleach and then dab it and then do another coat. You have to take intervals in between to see because it takes a few seconds for the bleach to activate and start bleaching the fabric. Don't spray too much because that will make the color really, really light. So spray some and then wait, watch the result and then spray more. And now I'm going to use a brush to apply some more bleach right in the middle of my design, right where the spider is, because I want this area to be brighter. And the brush gives me a little more control to reach out to these tiny areas and spots and apply bleach only on that specific area. And I am done. There you go. I'm very happy with the result. The bleach has dried completely. It has a nice glow in the middle right here, and it's spreading very nicely on the side. That's why I said I use a water spray, because you get a nice gradient effect. Now all we need to do is just peel the hot glue stencil that we have here and then reveal the design. So let's do that. So all you need to do is just pull the hot glue like that, and it will peel off very easily. And once you remove the stencil, you will see your design. Look at that, how nice my spider web is looking. All right, look at that, looks pretty beautiful. The stencil is out, the design is ready. Now let's wear this and see how it looks like. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful. If you did, then please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like it, and share it with your friends. And if you haven't, then please subscribe to my channel. I keep reminding you guys, because I want our art community and our art family to grow. So please subscribe, and please get your friends to subscribe to my channel. Also, let me know in the comments below your thoughts, your suggestions, your feedback. Love to hear it. Alright, that's the end of the video. I'll see you guys in my next one with another fun DIY project. Till then, remember to do good and be good. Peace!